the old goat.
Let's go!
I've got a bad feeling about this. It's not like him to be away for so long.
Don't worry. We'll find him.
He's not as young as he used to be. What if he's hurt himself?
Your father can still handle himself just fine, Miss McFarlane. He's built like an oak.
You're probably right, but I can't help worrying. He's all I've got.
Don't you have any brothers or sisters, Miss McFarlane?
I had six brothers, but five of them died, either from sickness or foolish choices.
And the other one?
He left for the East and never came back. Must be getting on for 10 years ago now. He's a high and mighty banker in New York, according to his last letter.
He should be here, helping you and your paw.
I don't want his help. He can live his life any way he wants. But when I see those city fellers coming in on the railway, all dressed up like a sore toe, I fear a little for his soul. He switched his saddle for a tie, and that's fine. I just never met a man in a tie I could trust. Who's that over there?
This'll fetch a good price. I don't think that's a good idea.
And you're no better. How many men have you killed?
Do you really want to know?
It's disgusting.
You never met the men I killed.
I heard the way you talk about that gang you were in. Like there was some twisted morality to what you did.
We all have a code. Only some of us don't realize.
The outlaw with the code? How wonderfully romantic. The reluctant murderer, the noble criminal. There's nothing more depressing than a man who's found a way to think the bad into good.
You're upset, Miss McFarlane.
Killing's killing, Mr. Marston. Between Pike's Basin and Thieves' Landing, it's a miracle there's any food left on the table.
You're talking like this ranch is already buried. You're surviving. Things aren't that bad.
Look, Mr. Marston, the barn is on fire!
Horses out!
They're trapped in there!